There's two people that influence our lives probably more than anybody else in the world. It's our mothers, of course, because we spent so much time when we were small, or at least if you were in a good family, you tried to. Our grandmothers and our school teachers. Teachers carried a big load for people, don't they?
Oh, they do. More so than most people realize.
So this is Mike Walker. He's a teacher and has been for over 30 years here in Northwest Arkansas area. And he's written a wonderful book called Seven Teaching Vignettes of Jesus. Teacher to teacher. Now, I looked at this and I'm going, okay, is this about Sunday school? What is this about? So tell me a little bit about your approach to teacher, Mike.
The book came about many years ago when I had student teachers from John Brown University working in my classroom. And I would oversee their teaching of my classes. They were in training. And at the end of the day, we would talk about what happened in class, how they felt about it. And then I would throw in what I call war stories, things that had happened to me and happened to other teachers that I knew. And at the end of the semester, one of them, I forget which one, told me, said, you know, you ought to write those stories down and share those with other teachers. And so that was the genesis of this book. And then I added a look at parables and also teaching techniques that Christ used. And it was actually the teaching techniques that caught the publisher's eye. It's a Revival Nation Publishing. And that's how the Seven Vignettes of Teaching subtitle came in. My title was Teacher to Teacher. And then when he sends it back to me with the cover, I see this on it. I said, what is that? He said, that's what caught my eye when I read your manuscript. Now we have this, you know, this book here.
Wow. So the whole purpose and point, though, is that relates specifically to teachers then?
It's directed at classroom teachers. It's meant to be an inspirational book. Each section is only a couple pages long, so that a teacher during the day could spend a few minutes, read a section, set it down, and go on about their day. Because teachers don't have a whole lot of time during the course of the day to sit down and read something.
So rather than being a devotional book that you read in the morning at breakfast that kind of becomes a habit and a ritual, this is something where that devotional book carries you through the day then.
Right. Say during your lunch break, and some teachers don't get much of a lunch break, you might have this with you, open it up, read for maybe 5 minutes, shut it, move on with your day. Hopefully you've gotten something out of it that'll help you kind of get motivated and continue on with what you're doing in the classroom.
What is your point? Do you plan to do a follow-up to the book?
Not necessarily directed towards teachers. I have one that does something similar that I'm working on that's going to be directed towards businessmen.
Oh, okay.
But
it will still be the same kind of format?
It will still be the same kind of format. This one is connected to Christ's parables. The next book will be focused on Christ's miracles. And making connection with what goes on in a businessman's day. It will also have a teaching classroom connection too, though. I can't get away from my teaching background.
Oh no, well, a teacher is a calling just as much as being a preacher or anything else is, for sure. Tell me about the first day when the box arrived and you opened it that had your book in it.
It was kind of like Christmas. I mean, it really was. There were no ribbons, there was no wrapping paper. But it was kind of like Christmas, seeing a box full of my books. And I had bought the books to take to different conferences. I had been offered a contract, so it's not a self-published book. It was a contract offered to me. But I wanted to take it out, and I wanted to take it to different teachers' conferences and things of that nature. And just try to spread it around. I didn't do it to make any money because most writers really don't make any money at their writing. Yes, you have the bestsellers, and those guys have the big names and big money. But the majority of writers in this country don't make a living doing this. You know, that's why, you know, I'm in the teaching profession. That's where I make my money.
Right.
That's where I make my living. This I do because I want to do it. I write because I love to write, and I love teaching and teachers. and I love the Lord. And so I combine all those things.
What was the first feelings of your family when they saw your book for the first time?
They had been after me for years to write because they had seen me dabbling. I used to write articles for newspapers and doing a variety of things. Did some writing for radio news, little bit of everything, really. And so they'd always been after me to write a book. Well, they always thought I would write the great American novel. And what they didn't know is that really secretly deep down inside, I didn't want to write the great American novel. As far as I was concerned, that had already been done. I wanted to do something that was a little bit more personal, a little bit closer.
Well, it's very relative, too.
Yeah, and something that I felt was needed. I'm not knocking fiction. I love fiction. But my heart is in writing this type of material.
All right. Well, I really appreciate the opportunity to visit with you and find out a little bit about you and your book and what your direction is. It seems that there's a mission with most writers. Just like you said, it's not about the money, even though that's nice too, because somebody's got to pay for it. But really, the message is priceless. And you found a way to deliver a message to people who need a message very bad in our country. I think teachers definitely need more support than they get. Yeah, in fact, I'm going to editorialize just a sec, because you're a teacher. This will be good for you.
Okay.
I think that teachers should be paid the same amount as doctors and be required to follow the same standards of education.
Well, you need to be head of the Department of Education is what I agree with you.
I'm way too opinionated to be in that kind of government. Well, I appreciate you being with us and telling us about it.
Thank
we hope
you.
You'll pick up the 7 Teaching Vignettes of Jesus by Mike Walker. It's called Teacher to Teacher. Real simple little book to read, but it's just full of nuggets of good wisdom and good things about the greatest teacher of all.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank
we'll
you.
Be back in just a second on the Out of the Norm show, where the stories are all about you, so don't you dare go.